Hey everyone, this is John Michael Swift. Welcome back to my looping series, and today I'm going to show you how to play the looping version of Tenerife Sea. I'm going to copy pretty much the exact version he did at Wembley Stadium. On the lesson page, the free lesson page that is linked in the description box of this video, I have a tab for the whole thing. Make sure you use it. It will be helpful. I also will kind of assume you've done the first lesson, like you know how to play a simple version. This is a little more advanced lesson, so I'm going to go a little quicker, and I'm not going to explain things in as much detail, but I will do a recap at the end where I play the whole thing, and you can see how I do everything. I'll start by breaking everything down and then do like kind of like a whole recap at the end so you can kind of see what's going on. But yeah, let's just start by breaking it down. Just, you know, use the tab below if you, you know, need it, and yeah. All right, let's go from there. So, got my RC50 here. I mean, you can do this, I think, with a two-track looper. This one is not so complicated as some of the other ones. I think you only need two tracks to do this one. So you could do this with an RC20 as well, or any other two-track looper. But it's nice to have the three sometimes. You can do some goofy things. So, the first thing that's a little different about this one is the intro. And you know, I transcribed pretty much exactly what I heard in the Wembley performance, but the main thing you got to know about the beginning is he's kind of playing with ghost notes. He's got this pattern. Like, that pattern is under everything, but his hands are just kind of like flitting around, and a lot of times they're not hitting all the notes. And you got to realize that he's kind of, you can, if you watch really carefully, his hands are moving around that 6/8 pattern and just kind of like, of swells the dynamics that way. So you can use your ear, you can mess with it, but realize that underneath you want to kind of feel this. You want to feel that, but sometimes you just kind of wave your hand in that pattern, and sometimes you let the dynamics get really, really quiet and then open up a bit. So I'll demonstrate that at the end, but that's the main thing you got to know, is that like he's got this lick. Kind of hammers on. He's got two on the D string, two on the B string, and he hammers through that. It's like you play the A string. I kind of hold this second note for luck, but it's mostly playing the third string and the second string, the fifth, second, and third string. So you kind of hammer, you wait, you roll, and you sort of play that pattern and hit the bass. So it's like roll the chord and hammer. Roll the chord, roll off, pattern, bass for the whole thing. Two and three. You kind of like fill in the pattern a little bit. Same thing. And I'll sort of pedal on these middle strings. Ding, digga, digga, down, digga, digga. Ding, digga, digga, down, digga. So this is what you're feeling underneath everything. So that is a little bit tricky. Let me see if I can break that moment down. This one's worth breaking down. It's very subtle, but it's kind of nice. So he kind of plucks like he did before. So he kind of, right on the one, he just plucks and sort of hammers with the pinky and then fills in the pattern. So what you want to hear is da, 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 da. That's the melody you want to hear. And what's really easiest to do, I think, is to focus on that melody and just fill in the gaps with the pattern. If I do it kind of slowly, it's, I'll do it even just a little bit slower. Highly encourage you to take that little moment and just break it down. Use the tab. It will really, really help with just the exact fingers you need to use. But it's a nice subtle little moment. And it's like you could like naturally repeat the bass melody with it, but letting that kind of like that lonely little hammer occur, it just is a really nice dynamic moment that's very soft. And little nuances like that really make this performance. Okay. So he kind of repeats that a couple times, and then he gets into the riff. And kind of plays all this. And he goes through the first verse and the chorus, and there's really nothing of special consequence there. The first looping he does is right during the first chorus. Let me make sure my looping mic's out of the way, because I don't want to loop the vocals. So you make sure the key is you need to use a parallel rig where you either have an off switch on your mic or you have a separate mic for looping, because you don't want to loop this part. You don't want to loop this part vocally. It's just on the guitar. So what he's going to do is he's going to play the same riff that he has, but he's going to start it with a strum. And usually what I do is I try to just finger, it's almost like fingering an E minor chord, finger the whole E minor chord, and just and loop that. So here we go. We'll start with that. It's like, so in love, so in love. So hit that loop. And then he basically goes, boom, chicka chicka crack, chicka chicka boom, chicka chicka crack, chicka chicka loop. Boom, chicka chicka crack, chicka chicka boom, chicka chicka crack. There's some other more subtle dynamics in his percussive loop if you want to try to get them, but the easiest way to understand it at first is boom, chicka chicka crack, chicka chicka boom, chicka chicka crack. And for his percussive hits, generally what he does, and so you really use the flat of his hand, so that not, you could do it right on the bridge there, but it, and for a lot of piezo pickups, it's not as strong. Sometimes it works. Sometimes I thud like that. Ed tends to really use the flat of his hand right there on these, right there near the bridge here, and it really gets a good bass thud across. So he's boom, chicka chicka whack, chicka chicka boom, chicka chicka whack, chicka chicka. It's a good easy 6/8 guitar percussion pattern. So you throw those things in there, they're going. So you bring those things back in, you're kind of going, playing along. So in love. You can kind of double it. So in love. What you're going to do is you're going to kind of whack the A chord again. So in love. And sort of do an all stop there and really whack it with the A string open with your fifth string, so that you kind of accent it and then also accent the downbeat when you bring it back in. So it's like an all stop, all start. You look so beautiful in this light, silhouette over me. And you can kind of finger pick along to double it a bit, make it a little deeper. And what he's going to do is when he gets to the third line, when he gets to the fourth line of each verse, he stops his guitar loop and plays the following C minor riff. So whenever he gets to, the way it brings out the blue, your eyes is the Tenerife Sea, and starts it again. Don't love the voices surrounding us here. I'll keep going. Let's fade out, you take a breath. Say the word and I will disappear into the wilderness. And it'll also stop the percussion loop. Should this be the last thing I see? And he'll go, excuse me. And then he'll go through the next bridge there and sort of bring them all back in for the chorus. So in love. And now he's going to start deleting them. So in love. He'll delete them one at a time, so in love, and keep this going. And then he'll start to record the bridge guitar loop. So what is this? The bridge guitar loop is, you know, the same sort of chords that he's done, these power chords, but he's palm muting. So what he's doing is he's palm muting the bass strings and letting the treble strings be open. So it sounds like, so my palm is kind of here down on these three strings, but not on these three. It's pretty common for a lot of finger picking techniques. So it's really useful to kind of just get a little bit of a cleaner A little more percussive, a little more bassy side of the sound. It's a nice complement to things. So the chords he does is he does four on the fifth string, the C sharp minor, I guess off capo fingering, does the A, it's an open fifth fret power chord. Then he does sort of the open E, that bass, and then the B chord, the second fret of the A string. So it's like four on the A string, open A string, open E, and then B. And then he kind of starts that again. Four on the fifth string, open fifth string, and then he does two on the fifth string twice. So it looks like the whole thing. I'll record the loop here. Ready, two, three, four, five, six. So in love, and just kind of ad-libbing over again. Now in love, I'm in love. And it keeps vocally going, oh, I'm in love. And it takes a whole cycle to vocally ad-lib over it. So in love, now in love. And it kind of gets his vocal mic, his looping mic. Now. And right on the downbeat of this, he's going to set it off. So basically, he kind of goes down a chord, and then he'll go back up in a second. But let me explain what I did there. So you kind of start on the mi of this key. If you're like, do, re, mi, if this is the do, he starts on do, re, mi, up in falsetto. Ooh, kind of goes, ooh, mi, do, re, do. Maybe easiest to follow it on your guitar. If you use your sort of, your first string, it'll be... just in like absolute fingering, 7th fret, 3rd fret, capo, 5th fret, 3rd fret, up to the capo, so play those, and then you go, and then you do 4th fret of the 2nd string off the capo, or I'm getting all mixed up with capo fingering. Try to watch my, do what I do, not what I say. That's your first voice. And then he sort of picks up almost right where he left off. He kind of like, kind of starts on the open E there. So open E, open B, second fret from the capo, open string, and then kind of hits open E, open B, open B. So that's your second harmony. And all these, they kind of like almost leave off where the last one picks up. It's like, and then right above that, and the next harmony starts right on that. Now you're in Ed tuning, so I'm gonna give you the fingering you use in Ed tuning, but it's really, So let's do open B, 4th fret of your 3rd string, which again is tuned to E. So open B, 4th fret of the 3rd string, 5th fret of the 3rd string, 4th fret of the 3rd string, open B, open 2nd string. 4th fret of the 3rd string, 2nd fret of the 3rd string. So again, one more time. So each one of those, really go over them with the guitar if you need to guide your voice, and then go as slow as you need to really get used to singing them in tune. And then, ideally, when you get that all in there, you should have this. Stack that kind of starts the same way. It goes like this. It's Unia, darling, Lumiere, oh, And but basically, the easiest way to think of these harmonies is basically just sort of like going down. You're sort of like, kind of just like starting at the top and sort of going down. So you've kind of gone, you started like, then you go, and then, and then you sort of like the next one starts with the words sort of right above where the last one ended off. You ended off, and then right up from there, Lumiere, darling, Lumiere over me. Now I like to add another one that's not normally there. He doesn't, but what he does is he leaves that there, and then he sings the melody in a lower octave and in a higher octave. He goes, Lumiere, darling, Lumiere over me. He does that in the falsetto octave, and then also, Lumiere, yeah, Lumiere, darling, Lumiere over me. He does it in the lower octave, and he basically just harmonizes that extra harmony he added in the two octaves. Now, I like to add in, Lumiere, darling, Lumiere over me. So that'd be like open B, fifth fret of the third string, open B, second, open 5-5, 5-2-0, and you can do two on the first string, open first string, fourth fret of the second string. So that's like an extra harmony that I like to add in there. Then you have three parts on each layer, which can be a little much, but it can also be really like juicy too. So let me see if I can add that other voice in there. And then what you're going to see is in the recap, is he basically just strips it back one thing at a time. I mean, I'll just explain real quick what he does in the recap. So after that, after he adds that harmony there, he sort of switches between the octaves, and then he's going to cut the guitar loop out and just sing with the vocal stack. Then he's going to cut the vocal stack out and just, like, brush the chords. Lumiere, darling, Lumiere over me. And he does that again, and then at the end, he kind of just, like... Should this be the last thing I see? And just kind of brushes along with all of that, and then finally ends with just the groove with him by himself. So in love, and goes out like that, and, you know, ends the song after he strips the whole thing back. So let me just demonstrate the vocal stacking really quick, and then I'm gonna do the recap. So here we go. So that gets added in there. There's one real quick thing I'll say before I go into the recap. I forgot to mention one thing. Notice how I kind of backed away from the mic. That last harmony is going to be in kind of a higher register. Maybe is another reason he doesn't do it. But I backed away from the mic to shade it a bit. Another thing he generally does in this song is he does this in looping in general. He dynamically shades it. This is really important. Have your phrases play back at a slightly lower level than you record them at. That's going to make the dynamics work a little bit better. So just mentioning that. I have another lesson on just dynamic shading, but just remember to do that. Shade your tracks just a little bit. So it'll help them kind of pop out when you put them in, but then also disappear when they're just loops. All right, here we go. Time for the full playthrough. Thank you. You look so wonderful in that dress. I love your hair like that. The way it falls down the side of your neck, down your shoulders and back. We are surrounded by all these lies and people talk too much. You got the kind of look in your eyes, no one knows anything but us. Should this be the last thing I see, I want you to know it's enough for me. 'Cause all that you are is all I'll ever need. So in love, so in love, so in love, so in love. You look so beautiful in this light, silhouette over me. Where it brings out the blue in your eyes is the Tenerife Sea. Don't look, the voices surrounding us here, let's fade out, you take a breath. Just say the word and I will disappear all into the wilderness. Should this be the last thing I see, I want you to know it's enough for me. It's all that you are, is all that I'll ever need. Oh, I'm in love, so 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 in love. So in love, now, now, now in love. So in love, now, now in love. Ah, now, now. Yeah. know it's enough for me. Cause all that you are is all that I'll ever need. Oh, wine and love. So in love. So in love. So in love. You look so wonderful in that dress. I love your hair like that. In the moment I knew you better. There you go. That is me teaching the Wembley version of Tenerife Sea by Ed Sheeran. I hope you dig it. I hope you find this series useful. Yeah, stick with it. Subscribe to the channel and learn more about other looping stuff, because eventually you learn a lot of looping songs. You acquire mad looping madness. Yeah, do that. Happy whatever the day is. See y'all later. Bye-bye.